There's an easy way now to create depth of field and 3D fog using the advanced 3D renderer in After Effects. I'll use the beta version of After Effects, as these options are now available there for the advanced 3D renderer in the same way they are working with the classic 3D and Cinema 4D renderers. To demonstrate it, I've opened this project where I'm animating another movie poster, this time for Metropolis, a 1927 German expressionist science fiction silent film directed by Fritz Lang. This movie is widely regarded as one of the greatest and most influential films ever made. In this almost final state of the poster, we can see Maria, which plays a critical and central symbolic role. She portrayed as a compassionate and charismatic figure who works to bridge the gap between the working class and the elite. Her role in the movie is complicated by a double robot created to incite chaos among the workers. Anyway, if you haven't watched this movie yet, you still have 3 years before we'll celebrate 100 years for this masterpiece work. I know most of you don't care about it, so let me cut down to the chase and quickly show you that this comp consists of a cutout of Maria, the robot, and circling around her are 6 shape layer rings. For each one, I applied the spin loop preset from the relatively new Adobe Express looping category, and then spice it up with turbulent displays, fast box blur, and optical glow from Red Giant VFX collection. Each revolving layer is also animated up and down to create this simple yet effective look. The more interesting part, I suppose, is the city comp, and this is using the advanced 3D renderer. As you can see, I have a 3D model of Metropolis cityscape courtesy of Janitor that posted on sketchfab.com. The link is down below in the description if you want to investigate it yourself. The camera that I've placed here is dolling slowly towards the buildings, while the title that I've modified is slowly appearing through the dark clouds. I've covered all of these techniques in previous tutorials, like this one for example, as well as this one. So feel free to go deeper by watching them if you haven't yet. And while you are on it, why don't you like those videos as well as this one? And maybe also subscribe to the channel. This will make it your channel as well and will encourage me and the YouTube algorithm to become better. Thank you. Alright, moving on. Back in the main comp level, we have both comps, one on top of the other, and I've also applied the Triton effect to the city comp to make it more bluish. However, the scene looks quite flat, even with the parallax motion of the camera. We can now make it more realistic by applying a few effects from the 3D channel category. And those effects can reference the depth data directly from the comp. Now, the rule is that this comp must stay a 2D layer, so don't enable the 3D switch or collapse its transformation, just leave it as is. Then I suggest to start with the depth of field effect. I'll apply it and set the maximum radius to 20, and then tab to the focal plane thickness. And since this is a quite deep scene, I'll set this value to 2000. Then I can play with the focal plane, and as I move it, we can see the depth of field effect in its full glory. To see it better, I'll turn off the Maria comp momentarily and continue to push those values. Now feel free to play with all 4 sliders until you land on the look that you like. Of course, you can also animate the focal plane to create a rack focus effect. Now, the main issue that I have with this effect is that it doesn't offer the repeat edge pixels option, so the blur doesn't calculate beyond the edge of the layer, and this may break the illusion and may not work for you. So I'll show you a better workflow in a moment, but before doing so, I quickly want to demonstrate the depth map effect, because I really love it. I'll apply it to the layer, And this effect will matte a layer by the overall 3D depth of the scene. By moving the depth slider, you can see how this works. In combination with the feather slider, you can expose just the parts that you need from the 3D comp. You can also invert those parts and combine it with the depth of field effect to achieve this unique look. All right, I'll switch both of them off and apply now the 3D channel extract effect, which displays auxiliary 3D data. So you can play with the black and white points to determine the disbursement amount of black and white levels, and then use these values as a depth map. So to demonstrate it, I'll duplicate the city comp, and for the upper copy, I'll remove all effects except of the triton and add to it the camera lens blur effect. For the blur map, I'll select the copy underneath, making sure to take under account the effects and masks, so it can reference the 3D channel extract effect. Then I'll set the blur radius to a higher value, such as 25, and notice that this effect has a better edge behavior, and by default, the repeat edge pixels checkbox is checked, meaning the blur is rendered beyond the layer's edges, which looks much better. You can now animate the blur focal distance to move the focus across the 3D depth and create a rack focus effect that looks even more realistic. You can also top it up with some 3D fog by adding the effect that goes by the same name. Then sample a color from the comp and move the fog start depth until you feel it's enough, and customize the fog appearance by changing the other parameters. For example, you can use a gradient layer that determines the fog influence. In this case, I'll unshine my layers and show you that I have a shape layer that I've placed named Gradient Map. Just to show you, this is just a simple ramp from black to white, and it can assist us to finesse the look of the fog by playing with its layer contribution slider, after defining it, of course, as the map for the 3D fog. Okay, I think this is looking much better compared to our starting point. Let me just turn off all the effects so you can judge for yourself. And now I'll turn them back on, as well as the Maria comp, and enable the clouds layer, which is a copy of the clouds that I'm using for the background, accompanied with the extract and glow effect. And I'll drag this layer above everything to add some mist and fog to the entire comp, especially the Maria robot layer. I'll also turn on the speaker for the audio that I've created especially for you, and then maximize the frame and preview the result. I'm so glad that we can now create depth effect using the built-in tools in After Effects. Remember that at the time of this recording, these options are only available in the beta version, so go ahead and test it yourself. And if you have any feedback, please add a comment down below, or even better, click on this little bubble to provide the feedback directly from the app to Adobe. Thank you so much for watching, and I will see you again in the next one.